Scott. We start with a Fox News alert. Count them, three different hearings on Obamacare today, all focusing on the key issue of cybersecurity for healthcare.gov. Welcome to HQ. I'm Allison Camerota.
I'm Bill Hemmer. Good day. A security expert who says the Obamacare site today is no safer from a hacker than it was when it was launched more than 3 months ago. Mike Emanuel's been watching and listening and is live now on the Hill. What did you learn, Mike?
Well, Bill, good afternoon. Some outside computer security experts call the security around healthcare.gov minimal and shameful. The Obama administration has been famous for saying there have been no confirmed breaches or hacks of the Obamacare website, but the truth is, according to this one security expert, he says the government doesn't really know.
The Security Operations Center, as of November 17th, had not been built or implemented, which means that they didn't have the security monitoring and detection capabilities to detect the attacks that are being mentioned here today. So to reemphasize, they don't know.
And they don't know. That's why they can say there hasn't been any. They're not in a position to know one way or the other.
That's correct.
Okay.
That expert says he and other experts are convinced healthcare.gov is a mess in terms of security and has not improved. At a separate Capitol Hill hearing, Medicare's chief cybersecurity official tried reassuring lawmakers and the public that the system now has a clean bill of health after the Obamacare site passed recent security tests.
Given the positive results of the recent security controls assessment, the ability to complete comprehensive security testing and a mitigation plan in place, I would recommend the FFM to be given a new authority to operate when the current authority expires in March.
There was some tension today, some Democrats accusing Republicans of trying to scare the public and try to keep the public away from going to the healthcare.gov website. Republicans reiterate that if there's a hack, it would be devastating in terms of the personal information out there. And some of the experts said today that those who developed this website did not consider security a priority.
Wow.
Bill?
Got to get it right. Mike, thanks. Mike Emanuel on the Hill. Allison has more now.
Lawmakers today also hearing from the government's own cyber experts who say they raised red flags about healthcare.gov's security before it was launched but were dismissed. Republican Congressman Jason Chaffetz sits on the Oversight and Government Reform Committee. Congressman, thanks for being with us.
Oh, glad to be here.
What did you learn today?
Well, just as you laid out, that's exactly right. You had the chief security officer for dealing with this. We heard testimony from three today. None of them would sign off on the security parameters, and yet Health and Human Services went ahead and launched the website anyway. So they refused to sign off, and yet it was launched anyway.
And why did they do that? Have you learned why, when these cyber experts raised some concerns, they were dismissed?
They had not done any of the security, or I should say any, they had not completed or done certain segments of the security testing. They didn't even try it. They didn't even see if the locks were working properly. I asked one of them, for instance, if the secure socket layers, the SSL as it's called, and how the JavaScript was working. She had no clue. I mean, she had absolutely no idea. I asked her what percentage of that data going across the line was encrypted at the beginning, how much of it is encrypted now. She didn't even know really what secure socket layers were, which scares the living daylights out of me. Anybody who knows anything about tech, you better darn well have that stuff encrypted as it goes across the wires.
So is it your conclusion that HHS was so interested, or the administration was so concerned about meeting the deadline and getting it online, that they ignored some of these cybersecurity issues?
They blew right by it. They didn't even do the testing. They didn't even have time to do the testing, let alone figure out what the results of that testing were. So to the point that Chairman Lamar Smith was making in another hearing, they didn't necessarily even know what was happening or not happening. And again, this has gone on for a long time. I don't have the confidence today that they've actually resolved that. If they can't certify to us and tell us that 100% of the data is going through a secure socket layer, That's what's scary about
this. So today, as we speak, it's your feeling that healthcare.gov is not secure.
It scares the living daylights out of me. When I had a chance, I did it in person. This is a huge, you're combining the IRS, Health and Human Services, your healthcare information, your credit card information. You got a lot of personal data. We have even a single breach of that, and it's going to be devastating to a family to try to get themselves back in order. That's what's so scary about this.
Congressman, where do you go from here? What more information do you need before you can take some sort of action?
Well, we need to understand why and how they made these decisions. They tried to portray it, Secretary Sebelius has tried to portray this as if it were law that they had to launch October 1st. That's not in the law. That was not the law. But somehow they blew past all the security parameters, the testing, and just said, hey, we're going to launch anyway. That had never, ever happened before. That's a testimony that we had heard from the three witnesses in the Oversight Committee. And we need some certification about the ongoing security of this information.
Do you want to interview Secretary Sebelius again, or are you looking for answers elsewhere?
I want the results. I want the truth. The secretary has got to take some responsibility. But when you have sitting before you the three people who's got the title chief in their name, information, security in front of you, and none of them can give you definitive answers about how the secure socket layer even works or JavaScript, then we got a problem.
All right, Congressman Jason Chaffetz, thanks so much for bringing to us what you learned in your hearings today. We'll talk again.
Thank you.